say, after 20 years, I've had a lot of practice selecting residents. You know, the residents get here the first day, and we sit in the auditorium, and they introduce themselves, and they're all nervous, and they don't know how to turn on the slit lamp, and they're really hopeless. And then, through, you know, a series of carefully designed experiences, magic happens. And then they come in as senior residents. Most of them I would have operate on me. In fact, there's very few that I wouldn't have operate on me. You know, they've risen to this extremely high level, not just as surgeons, but also as physicians, you know, being able to connect with patients, being able to guide patients through the journey of their illness. They sort of develop mastery. And that process never fails to amaze me.
When I was applying, interviewing all over and thinking about what kind of program I wanted to be at, I remember coming here and feeling like the people here were as smart as they were at all the top programs, as accomplished as they were at all the top programs. The opportunity seemed wonderful. I think people here had a great sense of humor and they seemed really happy. And that stood out to me. I felt like the place couldn't have more to offer, but nobody was on their high horse about it. And I thought that was a really wonderful thing that drew me in.
I had determined before making my rank list and even attending interviews that I wanted to go somewhere that was clinically busy. And UCLA really fit that bill.
You're not gonna just get one ptosis here, one ptosis repair, you're going to get 20, I think. You're not gonna get one trabeculectomy, you are going to get at least 7 to 10, and some residents get even 15. So that is a huge strength and I think really differentiates our program.
It's a very honest program. There's a lot of patients to see here and there's a lot of great work to be done. And I knew that if I came to Los Angeles, I would get to be a part of that and get really excellent training. And it's turned out to be extremely true that you get to see lots of patients. And the only way you get better at ophthalmology is by seeing patients. So it's been a tremendous experience.
So I chose Stein because of the strength of the clinical training here. And that comes from several different components. I think first, you have access to this wide variety of faculty. I think the words you said on the interview were depth and breadth of faculty who are enthusiastic and passionate clinical educators, as well as masters of their field and specialty. Like for example, Dr. Coleman's president of the AAO now, and there are similar titles across the entire institute. The second component is there are many different settings that you can practice in, which plays great for a graded autonomy type of learning. We have two counties, Harbor and Olive, as well as a Veterans Administration, and residents also rotate through the Stein clinics.
It's always been an extremely strong program, but the changes we've been able to make in the past 8 to 10 years have really taken it to a different level by making it a little bit more organized, friendly, yet maintaining the utmost level of expectation for our residents and training them to become the top surgeons and clinicians in the country.
I think as a first year, it can be intimidating meeting the big names that you see on the front of your textbooks, and I've been impressed with every single faculty that lectures to us or meets us, gives us their cell phone number and says, text me, call me anytime if you have questions, come to my OR. Multiple faculty have welcomed me as a first year into their operating room, you know, without having met me before that moment, and been incredible teachers in that context. So I think it's been wonderful to be so welcomed.
You're often challenged to learn something and then quickly begin incorporating that into your practice. First year residents even are quickly the experts on campus. We're asked by ER doctors, attendings from other specialties for consults to make decisions about the eye quickly. And I really feel like UCLA prepares us well to do that.
And one great thing and unique thing about Stein is that residents learn early to be independent and have grace under pressure. While there's always backup available, the residents are the first line primary on calls, and they're the ones who triage these things, and they're not shadowing anyone when they're going in to take care of patients. So a lot of the times, they are the primary person, primary care provider, and that is how the memory of how to manage difficult and emergent conditions sinks in and becomes part of you, your practice for the rest of your life.
we get to be part of that surgery and really learn how to do a methodical, thorough scleral depressed exam working one-on-one with the fellow. So it's a chance for us to sit down, for there to be one-on-one teaching, and to really learn how to do that exam well under a controlled circumstance. So that's something that really helped that exam technique click for me, and I was grateful that I got to see that early in the year.
So in really almost no time at all, I didn't have a reason to call my seniors because I had already been through the entire process by just putting in extra hours overnight at the hospital and working through it. Same thing with doing initial procedures. Your chiefs, your fellows, your attendings here, they'll let you struggle just enough where the patient's still gonna have a good outcome, but you're really going to learn how to do it.
Now that I've finished residency and I'm seeing people on my own, I realize that this residency really makes you the absolute best comprehensive ophthalmologist that you can be. And that's extremely important when you're out on your own, that you are comfortable managing everything, because you may not always have people there to help you out and provide you feedback. So if you're comfortable with all aspects of ophthalmology, that's really going to make you an outstanding clinician.
I'm always learning new things from the resident. They ask interesting questions. Their train of thought is just different than mine is at this stage of my career, and so I think that their perspective allows me to think about patients in different ways, allows me to think about diseases in different ways, and it's a sort of an ongoing process of learning, not just for obviously the trainees, but also for the attendings.
Very satisfying seeing them develop and getting to know them better, and then the transition, of course, from once they leave the training program, from trainees to colleagues. Then being able to see them throughout my career at meetings, etc., and be able to interact with them, again, see how they've developed, see what's going on with their family and with them, it's very satisfying.
The majority go on to do great work, whether it's in a clinical practice or academic medical center, and many of them do become leaders in their fields, whether it's just clinical medicine or academics, they gravitate towards leadership positions, and that's very, very rewarding and inspiring to all of us.
You know, I try to teach the residents some things, but I don't teach them as much as the fellows or the residents do. But what I can do is try to inspire them. And then I think back to the paying forward part, where the people that have gone through the program that inspired me, I still draw on those relationships sometimes when I have a tough problem, when I'm trying to figure out my way through the world. And so I really feel the magic of that bond, of the mentorship bond between faculty and resident. We have a lot of mechanisms here to have that happen with different organized mentorship programs, but most of all, I think it comes from the fact that our faculty are genuinely passionate about training. They remember the great mentors in their life, and they embrace the privilege of mentoring the next generation.
There's this amazing kind of depth in every field here. There's four or five faculty members that you can choose from. You can use them all as mentors. You can choose one that, you know, particularly whose interests align with yours. And those are relationships that you keep with you forever, whether you stay on board here, you stay in Los Angeles, you go out to wherever you go.
We are surviving in Southern California. We are all surviving.
I tell you what, no matter how hard the day might seem, when you get a walk out and the sky is blue and the palm trees are swaying and the ocean's just a little bit away, you realize it's such a great thing to live here in Southern California.
I was thinking about this today too, like getting called in the middle of the night, okay, I have to go into the ER. It's not Chicago in the winter.
No.
You don't, like, you can get out of bed, like, you're comfortable, get in your car. It's not so bad.
Yeah.
I actually think that's a trick question, because the entire residency is supposed to be a fun experience. And actually, I look forward to going to clinic every day, because it's working with your teammates who you like and enjoy, as well as with faculty who are extremely friendly and involved.
So much fun, and we're so incredibly blessed to have them home and experiencing Los Angeles. You know, the weather is constantly gorgeous. We live at the UCLA family housing with a bunch of other residents and their kids. So Elizabeth and Nicholas have friends that they see on the playground. They're running around. It's a beautiful place to be outside year round.
And they truly are humbling in all the work that they do. It's just incredible. Not only here at UCLA, but in our community and around the world, many of them are very involved in programs in foreign countries and helping to raise ophthalmology standards throughout the world. So we have a very passionate, committed faculty here at the Stein Eye Institute.
And not just be a good practitioner, but really try to be part of the future leadership of the field should be very interested in this program. We can make them leaders like nobody else.